Hello and welcome to Python Fundamentals. In this course, we learn the underpinning Python programming skills, preparing for our journey towards mastering the Django framework and the Python programming language. This tutorial is part of a series of tutorials. You can find the link to the whole playlist in the video description. This tutorial is from our Python Programming Fundamentals for Django Developers course, which you can find and purchase on Udemy. You will find all the latest and updated tutorials, as well as resources and assessments to help accelerate your learning of the subject. The link to the course, which will always provide the best price, can be found in the video description. Let's now go through the motions of creating a new variable and assigning values in Python. For this example, you don't necessarily need to open up your Django application that we are building throughout this course. Let's just go ahead and create a new file. I'm just going to call this example. example.py. I'm sure that's a bug. Right. So example.py. So here we've created a new Python file, .py extension. It's just a blank Python file here. So let's go ahead and create a variable. So unlike other languages, we don't necessarily need to, or there is no command for declaring a variable in Python. We simply just need to create a name and then assign a value. Like we saw in the previous tutorial, we described the name as a symbolic link that's utilized to access the data that we're going to store in RAM. So let's go back and now create our name. So let's just call this username. So that's the name of the variable. And then we need some data. So this is where we need to start to learn a little bit about data types. Although the next section of this course is dedicated to it, we are going to need to know a little bit of information for us to start to learn about different values. So the value on the right-hand side here, depending on what we want to store, depends on how we present the data here on the right-hand side. So if we're looking to store strings, characters, etc., we are going to need to use the double or single quotes here. So this will create a data type called a string. So let's just store in here, hello world. So we're going to store a string here in this variable. So what's happening now when we run this piece of code, this is going to be read. It's going to instantly create a new variable. And of course, that means that we are going to build a container, sometimes described as a container, or we're going to build or store this value into RAM. And this name here is going to be the way in which we can retrieve and change this data that's stored in memory. Now we can go ahead and just showcase that that is the case. So we're going to use the built-in print function. More about that later in this section of the course. So we're going to type in the name of the variable. Remember, the name of the variable is how we're going to access the data. We do that, and then we go ahead and run this piece of code. So I type in Python 3, and if you're on Windows, just py, and then the name of the file here, example.py. And you can see that is going to print to the terminal the word hello world. So what's happened here then is this program has run. Python has stored this value into memory. We've got the reference to it via username, the name username. And then we've gone ahead and we've just printed that out. So when we print this out here, we've returned the data from memory, this value, and then we've gone ahead and converted that into a string if it wasn't already, and then printed it to the terminal. As I mentioned, we will discuss data types later on in the next section of this course, but just to give you an idea, if we wanted to create another variable, for example, with the age, then if we wanted the age to be a different data type, say for example, an integer, which is a whole number or a float, then we don't need to use the double or single quotes here. We simply just assign the number, in this case, 1 or 10 or 100 or 100.00 and so on. So let's go ahead and print that. So we have the age, just to zoom out a little bit here. So if I go ahead now and run this program, you now see that we're storing two values in RAM or memory, and then we're retrieving it using the variable name. We need to be careful. Throughout our program, not all variables are stored in the same place. We may have a piece of code, which is 100, 200, 300 lines of code, and we can place a variable wherever we deem necessary. So we need to ensure that we're not using the same names. So for example, this piece of code here is interpreted from top to bottom, processed by Python from top to bottom. So if I were to change the age here, what's going to happen initially when this code runs, hello world is going to be stored, age is going to be 100 and stored in memory, and then we're going to overwrite. We're now saying, well, have a look at that variable which has already been assigned to and stored into memory, and we're going to overwrite it with new data. So if we were to run this, you can now see in actual fact age, which is referenced twice here, is now returning 101. So it is important that we are careful about naming our variables and avoiding any duplication.